But it's been very, very clear as I've gone door to door. People want us to move forward. I think this hopefully is a referendum on whether or not we should focus on the past, which is 2020, or move forward to 2022 and beyond. I'm going to take it as a referendum to say, let's move on. So there's no doubt in my mind that we will still focus on the election reforms that have to happen that were vetoed by the governor, but not talking about 2020 and somehow overturning that election, which is constitutionally impossible.
Do you think that was the key factor in the... It's what your opponent based his campaign on.
It's really the only difference. He was very clear, and I have been too, that I think for the most part we believe the same things. I was endorsed by the NRA, Wisconsin Right to Life, all of those groups. He chose to run a campaign that was mostly negative, focused on lies about my record. But ultimately, the only real difference was that I think that we should move forward, that we can't decertify or overturn the election. He thought that we could. We now have, hopefully, that's settled, and we can move forward and talk about the future, not the past.
The former president also believes that the 2020 election should be overturned, and he's endorsed Tim Michaels. Is there a split in the Republican Party in this state?
I don't think so. I mean, I think the problem is people are really frustrated with the awful job that Joe Biden is doing. We see the chaos, inflation, food prices, all the things that are happening and affecting everyday Americans. That's what I heard when I went door to door. People want us to focus on ways to make their life, their school, their future better. I think that when Tim Michaels begins the general election campaign and focuses on the contrast with him and Tony Evers, people are not going to be talking about Donald Trump. They're going to be talking about hopefully a new Republican governor and a failed Democrat, one that has to be recovered.
So you're heading back to Madison, and when you do, are we done investigating the 2020 election?
I certainly think we're going to move forward. We have done our due diligence to try to be able to show all the flaws that occurred in 2020, because as you know, I do believe there were problems in 2020, but we need to be able to pass legislation to fix those. The only way to do it is by getting Governor Michaels into office.
All right, Robin Vos, the Assembly Speaker, reelected tonight in a narrow margin, but he's headed back to Madison again as Assembly Speaker.